But I'm just not. Right, shorthand speed. 80 words per minute, 10 minutes speed, 80 words and 10 minutes speed, 5 seconds. 5 seconds. Now write down. In the recent past, there has been a tremendous rush for the technical examination. This is because the students feel that they get a job if they pass some technical examination, but the performance of the candidates at all these examinations is not up to the mark. This is because of their poor standard in English. Good standard in English is particularly necessary for the students who learn shorthand. Shorthand is an art. It is only learning to write by sound. It is not that everybody can learn this subject. The student who is prepared to do hard work only can learn this art perfectly and thoroughly. This is a subject which cannot be learned by self-study. Students who intend to learn shorthand must always get sufficient training from a qualified and competent teacher. The pronunciation of the teacher should be clear and perfect. The student should have full and thorough knowledge of outlines and see that the outlines written by him are clear in accordance with the rules of shorthand. He should also have thorough idea of gramologues, contractions and several phrases. His practice must be regular and systematic. To a great extent, the student must judge for himself the method of practice. While taking dictation, ear and hand should work practically simultaneously in order to secure best results. When a wrong outline is written, the student has to ignore the fact and go on. If several outlines are wrongly written, he has to reduce the speed. One should have regular dictation practice to improve speed in shorthand. Particular attention should be given to length, position writing, and indication of vowels of the outlines. Practice of an hour a day is better than 2 or even 3 hours every alternate day. To improve the outlines, one should have daily practice of writing shorthand from written English passages. The passage should be varied as far as possible. Difficult words, if any, should be practiced separately and they should be noted down in a separate notebook. Marking of punctuation cannot be overlooked. Another factor is concentration. While taking dictation, the mind should be calm and undisturbed. The student should have full concentration on the passage. All this can be developed only through regular dictation practice. The students should not be eager to take the examination when his practice is not up to the mark. Practice of shorthand should not be examination oriented. Even if he fails in the examination, there is no need to be disappointed. Failure is to be considered as an opportunity to strive for perfection. Even after the examinations are over, it is good to have continuous practice. Otherwise, when he takes up a job, it will be difficult for him to cope with the work. If he makes mistakes while transcribing the passage, the officers will form a poor impression of him. Therefore, there is every need for regular, systematic, constant, sincere, and continuous practice of shorthand for all those who want to take up this profession. Apart from regular practice in shorthand, everyone must develop the habit of reading at least some of the popular good English books. This habit helps in developing good vocabulary, spelling, and good style of writing correct English. A person who is desirous of joining this humble profession should additionally develop personal qualities like good manners, regularity, sincerity, and honesty. Dear sirs, in response to your kind inquiry of the 20th instant, for which we thank you, we have pleasure in enclosing herewith a copy of our new illustrated catalogue, which has been specially prepared for the Bangalore season. The prices quoted are subject to a discount of 10% for cash in a month from the date of invoice. Under separate cover, we have sent a few samples of fine light colored shirtings and suitings, which we are able to supply on very favorable terms. We will ask our representative, who will be in your city next week, to call on you on Friday next. He will be in a position to answer any questions about price and delivery, and we hope we will receive a large share of your patronage. We regret to note that the last consignment of shirtings and suitings reached you in a damaged condition. Our manager assures us that the goods left here were in perfect order. Under the circumstances, we think that railway authorities are entirely responsible. Perhaps you will be kind enough to make necessary inquiries and let us know the result as early as possible. Should the prices quoted be acceptable, we shall be much obliged if you will kindly place an order with our representative when he calls on you during his coming visit, awaiting the favor of your early orders and thanking you in the meantime. Yours faithfully.